Hello, hello, Stephanie Marrone here with another one of my videos. You may have noticed somebody's missing here, and that's Remy. It used to be Steph and Remy, but she's retired. She's off chasing kitties and flies. But I'm still here, and I'm just getting started. And please be sure to look out for my new videos that come out the first Tuesday of every month, where we cover all things San Francisco Bay Area, real estate, and lifestyle and livability. Today, I thought we'd discuss a topic that's very true to my heart, empty nesters. I happen to be one. And I want to share with you the 7 mistakes we tend to make. We'll discuss. Stay tuned. One of the biggest mistakes empty nesters make is they change their spending habits too quickly. They start going out to dinner all the time and spending money on vacations because they think that without the kids in the house, their expenses are gonna go way down. That's a no-no. They really don't go down as much as you think they do. So definitely wanna make sure that you don't end up going out to dinner so much that it ends up exceeding your grocery bill back when the kids are in the house. You just wanna keep an eye on that. Number 2, you wanna make sure to update all of your financial documents. This is a great time to do it. Your family is probably gonna do nothing but grow from here. It's probably a good idea to put your estate into a trust because old, outdated documents can cause nothing but problems in the future. Number 3, not getting sound advice. There are actually marketers out there that target empty nesters and try to sell you luxury vacation homes and cars. This is not a time to turn away from people that are your trusted advisors. Just don't be quick to sign anything or invest anything without getting advice, and make sure it's in your best interest. Number 4, paying too much for entertainment. We're so used to our kids being our source of entertainment after all these years. We have to sort of reinvent ourselves and figure out ways to entertain ourselves, and a lot of times we end up just throwing money at it and spending a lot more than we're used to. Number 5, not updating your home before you sell it. Now, chances are you've lived in your home for a very long time and most likely a lot of things are outdated. Well, I'm here to tell you it's very important, I know this as a realtor, to go ahead and do the necessary updates. And by that I mean definitely declutter, get all your personal objects out of there. Go ahead and spruce up the landscaping, paint inside and outside of the house, that gives it a fresh new look. And maybe even paint some of the cabinets in the bathrooms and kitchens. This is a good way to give it a nice fresh look, and you'll definitely recoup your money in the sales price. Number 6, conversely, spending too much on renovations. You definitely don't wanna be spending hundreds of thousands of dollars to get your house ready to sell. You're not gonna end up recouping it. So we call it the Goldilocks approach. Just right. Find that happy medium that you're sure to get your money back that you've put into it. Number 7, no longer being active. A big mistake when you become an empty nester is becoming stagnant. Sitting is like the new smoking. Yep, I said it. I definitely recommend finding hobbies that keep you active and moving. It will help you live a longer life and will reduce those medical bills. Get out there and move. I hope you've enjoyed this video on the 7 mistakes that empty nesters tend to make, and this new version of Stephanie without Remy, although she's sitting right here. Hello. Please stay tuned to my next video and be sure to watch out for my video that comes out the first Tuesday of every month. And as always, thanks for watching.